y'all, this is Bethany from Southern Couture. I'm excited today to share a really fun DIY, handmade, whatever you want to call it, Christmas gift idea that you can make too for those special people in your life, and I think you're going to love it. So if you head down to the description, there is a link to my blog post today that will give you all the nitty gritty on making this really fun handmade tea towel, starting with the Cricut Maker, how to cut out the different materials, and walking you through that whole process. I just want to kind of walk you through it and share with you a little bit about how to put it all together once you get the stuff cut out and how to use the Easy Press too. So that's what I'm going to show you here today. As you see, this is such a fun idea to make a gift personalized. So I know women in my life that love to bake and be in the kitchen, especially during Christmas. And so I thought it would be fun to have this tea towel for them that they could put up in their kitchen while they're baking, and just have it as a fun little decoration. So you can make it according to whatever style their taste is. And then one really fun thing that you can do, since you're making it yourself with the maker, is customize it with their own initial or a monogram. So I did this one with some glitter iron-on. I have the whole design for cutting out the monograms or the letters, and also the little candy cane. That cut file for Cricut's Design Space is over on the blog too. There's a link to it. So if you want to make this one, you can click on that link. It'll take you right to Design Space, and you can customize it with whatever letters or whatever you want it to do. So what I did was I cut out that iron-on. These are iron-on designs that you see here. And what I did was this came as one big sheet that you could, put on a shirt if you wanted. But I just cut out the different elements that I wanted from it and made it work for me for this project. Obviously, I didn't want that big thing on a towel. They also have these really fun ornaments that you can do, which I have used the red. There's some that are bright red in this pack, and I love it. And you just cut them out and use them how you want, and it's, all the work's already done for you. So even if you didn't have a maker and you were waiting to get one, you could get the iron-on designs that Cricut has. I'll link all the supplies I'm using as well in the description, and you could do this as a little fun gift idea. Now, the other thing that I did is made this little tag that's personalized, but also can be used as an ornament once they open their gift, which I love. And I'll show you the other one that I have here. It was just a little candy cane shape. This is leather, and I love the rose gold leather, which makes it great for an ornament that would last for many years. The maker did cut out the leather, which is incredible. And then I cut out a little piece of paper in the same shape and size for my tag, which you then can write who it's to, or you could even have the Cricut write it if you wanted with the pens. It will do that too. Now, you'll see this really fun detail here that says Merry Christmas. This was engraved using the quick swap tools from the for the maker, which is so fun. So you can deboss with the maker, engrave, and do all sorts of other things with their different tools that you can switch out, which I love. So it doesn't just cut, which is really fun. And I just love that little Merry Christmas touch that's very subtle, but will be really fun hanging on the tree for a little ornament. I used this little tool that has a really, really sharp point on it. This is like from their paper crafting tool set, and very carefully just poked a hole through that. It comes with a little mat that you can use too, so you don't poke yourself. And then you just punch it through with make a hole in both of those. I strung the baker's twine through it and then tied it off. And then at the end, I put this black ribbon on here. I liked how it matched with the design, and then just took the baker's twine, looped it over one of the ends of the ribbon, and hung it on there so it kind of disguises it. And then, of course, you can go back and fluff your ribbon and make it look pretty like you want. And that's all there was to it. So I love that. But what I want to show you is over here I have the Easy Press. And so you kind of see the whole thing put together. You can see how I did the tag, which is more self-explanatory. But with the iron-on designs, what I really love is the Easy Press 2. This is the medium-sized one. There is a smaller, medium, large, and then the mini. I have a post all about all of them that if you do not know about the Easy Press, I will link it down below and you can check out more information about it. But I'm going to go ahead and just show you what I did. Was I have my settings here that you would use for the iron-on designs, and Cricut has an interactive guide online that I'll link to. And what it does is you can put in what material you're ironing on, like this would be the glitter iron-on, and then what material you're ironing it on to. And this little towel is 100% cotton. So I put all of that in there, and it told me that it needed to be at 350, and it actually was for 50 seconds. I like to sometimes go down to about 30 as my max, just to, you know, check on it, make sure it's not burning it too much or causing it to peel or do anything funny. And then I can go back and do it a second time, and that's what you do. So you can change your heat here. You can change how long you want the timer. You go up and down for your heat and timer as well. And then when you're ready to start, you would obviously put this over on your material. I use a protective mat. You could use a towel. Then this would start your timer, as you can see. So I've had this on, it's very warm, so I'm gonna go ahead and turn it off. But that is basically it. It's on this really nice base too, so it protects your work surface. You don't have to worry about it burning anything. And that's all there is to it, guys. So you could make a little handmade towel for somebody to hang in their kitchen this Christmas. I think it's fun. You might think, what, Christmas already? But what's great about it is homemade gifts start early, so you're not so stressed at the last minute trying to make something or come up with an idea. You already have it done, and you'll have fun while you're doing it. Put on a good Christmas movie and you're good to go. So if you have any questions about this, let me know. Like I said, the full tutorial, that cut file, over on the blog today with a link down below where you can grab that. And any of the supplies I used, I'll have those linked down below too. Any questions, just leave them for me and I will get back with you as soon as I can. Make sure you are subscribed and then click that little bell icon so that you will know when the next video is coming out. And I just appreciate all y'all's support. I hope you love this little video. And stay tuned. I'll be back again very soon sharing some of my top favorite like a little gift guide, if you will, for beginners using the Cricut. In case you know of someone that wants a Cricut, what you might get them to go along with their machine, or maybe for yourself to tell Santa. So stay tuned for that, and I'll be back again then. See y'all then. Bye-bye.